Mr. Ambassador, it's an honor to have you here in Greece, and we would like to thank you very much for this interview to theDiplomat.gr. Japan and Greece enjoy close relationships. Are there any future plans for Japanese investments in Greece, and if so, in what sectors?
Business relations between Japan and Greece has been developing a lot for many years. But unfortunately, due to the recent economic crisis, our economic relations become a bit stagnant recently. But I'd like to just take a look at the positive side, and for instance, the automobile maker Toyota, or television game maker Nintendo, or Japan Tobacco International, or Takeda Pharmaceutical Company, or Mizuno Sporting Goods. These companies operate in Greece. But there's no Japanese businessmen working for these companies, and all of them are localized. So it contributes to the employment of the Greek people instead of the Japanese businessmen. And they have been doing very well. So that in this sense, the investment has been very successful from Japan. I think the Greek side should make further efforts to invite Japanese companies, or create the atmosphere which enable Japan-related companies to run the business smoothly. For instance, the Greek government should accelerate its reform so as to abolish the capital control as of now, as soon as possible. So we also expect, hope that the Greek government should establish sort of clear and strong industrial policy.
Well, Japan has a very developed high-tech sector. Do you actually envisage any sharing of know-how between the two countries?
This is a new thermal electric power station, in Putore Maida near Kozani in the northern part of Greece. A Japanese major electric company, Hitachi, has participated in this project. And this power station will use the brown coals imported from the Balkan Peninsula countries. And Hitachi is specialized in dehydrating low-quality brown coals. Hitachi made a successful bid for this big project, and this power station will be completed by 2019 or 2020. Mm-hmm. But anyhow, through this project, I think the sort of technology transfer will be made, and the Greek people will learn from the Japanese cutting-edge technology.
Are you actually planning to come to an agreement with the Greek government and the Greek tourism agency in order to boost these mutual visits?
This country used to be a very popular tourist spot for the Japanese people until recently. Some 10 or 20 years ago, the more than 100,000, probably 130,000 tourists came from Japan. But now this has dropped to only 10%, around 13,000. Before economic crisis, we had the 60,000 or 70,000 people here, the Japanese tourists here. But after economic crisis, the number dropped to this number, the small number. Because in Japan, the bad image of Greece has developed, unfortunately, through the television, the news, or other fighting in the Syntagma Square, or so this image gave the sort of bad image among the Japanese people. And also there are some competitors of the inviting tourists emerged. I mean, for instance, the Turkey or Croatia or some Balkan countries now attract more and more Japanese tourists. 20 years ago, very few people went to these countries. But now, unfortunately, this country, Greece, lost the competitive power against these countries. And the Japanese tourists go to the everywhere. There are some good development to increase the number of the tourists last year. This is because Mrs. Olga Kefaroyani, who was a former Minister of Tourism, went to Japan almost 3 years ago, and she promoted the tourism. And responding to that, I think the many Japanese people came last year. I think the number almost reached 20,000. But I don't know, this year, again, the sort of a crisis happened and bad image prevailed among the Japanese. Mm-hmm. So unfortunately, for instance, the last summer, I really wanted to welcome a couple of the Japanese groups, but they canceled their trip, unfortunately, mm-hmm. because of the bad Greek situation. It's a sort of the bad rumor, just a rumor. Mm-hmm. So we have to rectify this rumor and to give the good image. And as far as I am concerned, I really enjoy visiting the various places of this country. Mm-hmm. Very beautiful and wonderful places, and I visited as many as 13 or 14 islands, and also all over Greece, this country. And I just found there's so many nice places where, in the future, I think the Japanese tourists will be visiting. But unfortunately, for instance, your tourist bureau or tourism bureau in Tokyo closed a couple of years ago, mm-hmm. due to the lack of finance, and so promotion is not big enough. But owing to some people, the Ministry of Tourism, I think we had a very close contact with that ministry, and Mrs. Kefaroyani met our vice speaker or vice president of the parliament 1 year ago, and they just agreed to promote the tourism mm-hmm. in Japan. And we made a big success at that time, but since the beginning of the year, I think the government changed, and no concrete plan has been made yet, but I tried to do my best to promote the tourism.
Mr. Ambassador, you said that many of the Japanese tourists normally visit the competitors like Turkey, Greece, and so on. Why is this? Why do they not prefer Greece?
One of the reasons why is that it's a bit expensive coming here because they have to change the airplanes. And in the case of Turkey, we have some direct flights, daily direct flights between Japan and Istanbul, mm-hmm. which bring a lot of the Japanese tourists and also the less costly, much cheaper, even for 1 week, costing only 1,000 euros or something like that. Mm-hmm. So people can afford. But in the case of Greece, I don't know why, but it's a bit too expensive to come here. And as for Croatia, I think former Yugoslavia, nobody or very few people went to these countries, but now the former Yugoslavia, including Montenegro and Slovenia, mm-hmm. they are now open for their tourists. And so for Japanese people, I have been already to Greece, and now let's go to the new place. Mm-hmm. This is a sort of decision, and also they make these governments, the Turkish government, the Croatian government, or these governments make their best effort to invite Japanese tourists as much mm-hmm. as possible through their embassies in Tokyo.
You experienced a terrible accident in Fukushima, and the Japanese economy has suffered a very strong blow. Has actually the economy recovered to begin with? And is this actually the reason why the Japanese investments, maybe in Greece, are fairly limited?
After Japan's economy was overwhelmed in 1980s, the recession started as early as 1990, mm-hmm. so that they are not only the Fukushima incident, but already some 20 years ago, the recession started. And our GDP growth rate was only 0.8% between 1993 and 2012, mm-hmm. for 20 years. And of course, the Fukushima accident and the reconstruction process of the tsunami and the earthquake. It costs a lot, and economic recovery slowed down, more or less. Mr. Abe, the current prime minister, came into the office just 3 years ago, and he tried to get out of Japan from the recession. He launched the three big policy, aggressive monetary policy, and flexible fiscal policy, and growth strategy. This is three arrows, so-called, and in total, we call the Abenomics. And the first two measures have been already discharged right after Mr. Abe came in. And it was very successful, and Japanese GDP growth and employment situation has drastically improved by these measures. But we have to take one more measure. This is the growth strategy to revitalize Japanese economy. We have to do more, for instance, the structural reform. It's on the way now. So that it's now recovering. By the way, that we have been negotiating the Japan-EU partnership, economic partnership agreement, so-called EPA, since April 2013. And the industrial sectors in Japan and also in the EU, of course, including Greece, has expressed high expectations of concluding this EPA, Economic Partnership Agreement, which will contribute to economic growth in both Japan and the EU through, for instance, tariff reductions or harmonization of rules and standards and the liberalization of investment. Mm-hmm. And I hope that after concluding this agreement, Japan will increase investment to the EU countries, especially including this country, Greece.
Obviously, there is a number of Greek citizens living and working abroad in Japan. Mm-hmm. What exactly are the relationships with the Japanese state?
Yes, I think the Greek citizens living in Japan are having their very, very happy lives there. The government of Japan has invited the several Greek students every year under the so-called Monbusho scholarship, provided by the Ministry of Education of Japan. And I met one of the alumni of this scholarship program last July in Tokyo. I happened to be in Tokyo at the time, and we invited the Cyprus Foreign Minister, Mr. Kasridis, to Japan. Mr. Kasridis visited the National Museum of Science and Innovation in Tokyo. Mr. Kodopros, who's got the Japanese scholarship, and he's one of the alumni. And he just introduced or guided him in the Greek language. Mm-hmm. So the Mr. Kasridis, the Cyprus foreign minister, was very surprised, and so he's very active in that very important museum, mm-hmm. where President Obama or Chancellor Merkel visited in the last 1 or 2 years.
There is a number of Japanese women married to Greeks.
Exactly, yeah.
And they have kids. They send them to Greek schools, or they send them to a Japanese school here in Athens. How do both these communities experience their living in Greece, and how do they interact?
The number of Japanese in Greece is not so big, but more than 700 Japanese people staying here. The large part of them are, as you said, the Japanese women who married Greek men, and their kids attend the Greek school or international school. The Japanese school closed some 10 years ago, unfortunately. Mm-hmm. These kids go to the various local schools and also international school. So one of my relatives, she married a Greek man, and they are living in Nisiros Island, mm-hmm. near Kos Island, and they are having a good life, and they are running the hotel or restaurant and welcoming a lot of tourists mm-hmm. in Nisiros Island, and they are doing the very well, having a very nice life, wonderful life in this country.
You also made a donation 2 years ago towards the monastery of Phanerōmeni in Salamina. Are there any similar activities in plan for supporting intercultural relationships?
Well, yes, I'm very pleased to that you mentioned this great project, the Phanerōmeni Monastery Reconstruction Project. This project was made possible by the financial support from the Japanese government and also Japanese private sector. Completion of that restoration project ceremony was made right after I came here, only 3-4 weeks after my arrival here. So I still clearly remember, and I really I was very much moved by the fact that the Greek people really appreciated our contribution to this project. I'd like to stress that since I came here, I put a big importance of our cultural exchange programs to promote our mutual understandings. Now, in Japan, since last week in Tokyo, the big exhibition, the Golden Legend, has been held, just started. And in this exhibition, half of the articles on display from the various Greek museums. It was very well received, accepted, or become popular by Japanese people. And more Japanese will enjoy this ancient Greek art items toward the next year in May.
Japanese shipyards receive orders for shipbuilding from Greek ship owners. I think they are worth over $2 million per year.
Yeah.
How does this relationship affect future investment purposes, if you like?
Due to the economic crisis, as I said before, I'm afraid to say that our economic creation becomes stagnant. But the shipping sector is totally exceptional.
Right.
3 years ago, our Prime Minister Abe launched, I said, the Abenomics, which led to the yen's depreciation. Then the price of Japanese-made ships has dropped significantly and sharply. And so Greek ship owner started to buy again the Japanese ships because the Japanese ships, made ships become competitive compared to the Korean made ship or China made ship. And I have been also told that the many Greek ship owners decided to purchase the Japanese-made ship because they are proud of, the Japanese ships are proud of high technology. And aftercare is very good. And so we really appreciate this kind of comment and, from the many ship owners. So I hope that the Greek ship owners will pay more attention to the Japanese high technology of the shipping shipbuilding sector.
In 2009, we celebrated the 110th anniversary of Greek-Japanese relationship and friendship. What should we expect for the future?
Next year, the Greek-Japanese Association in this country will celebrate its 60-year anniversary of its establishment, 60-year. So we plan to conduct more cultural exchange programs to celebrate this anniversary. So we are ready to do so towards next year. In May next year, we are going to invite the very famous popular Japanese violinist, Ryu Goto, and he's going to play with the Essence State Symphony Orchestra in May next year. This is a sort of the special present for the Japanese Greek Association to celebrate the 60 years anniversary. Probably you know that Tokyo is going to host the Olympic Summer Olympic Games, Olympics and Paralympic Games in the year 2020. Of course, the Greece is the birthplace of the Olympic Games, so that they will be able to collaborate towards the success of our Olympic Games in 2020.